JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for March the 17th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded mixed against the other G10 currencies on Tuesday and during the Asian session Wednesday. It gained ground against NOK, NZD, the Euro and AUD in that order, while it underperformed versus the Canadian dollar, SEK, CHF and the British pound. The greenback was found virtually unchanged against the Japanese yen. The weakening of the risk-linked Kiwi and Aussie, combined with the strengthening of the safe haven franc, suggests that markets traded in a risk-off fashion yesterday and today in Asia. Indeed, looking at the performance in the equity world, we see that although major EU indices were a sea of green, risk appetite softened during the US session and remained soft in Asia today. With no clear catalyst behind the change in market sentiment, we believe that investors may have adopted a cautious stance ahead of the FOMC monetary policy decision later today. Following the most recent surge in US Treasury yields, some market participants may be on the lookout on any comments on that front, whether the Fed is considering to react, and if so, how. While the rally in yields was fueled by speculation that the Fed may have to tighten policy sooner than previously anticipated due to surging inflation, we don't expect policymakers to act to such expectations. After all, when testifying before Congress, Fed Chair Powell clearly noted that they will look beyond any temporary spikes in prices and that it may take more than 3 years for inflation to reach the Fed's goal. Remember that the Fed wants inflation to rise above 2% for some time, something which, according to the minutes of the latest FOMC gathering, is expected to happen in the years after 2023. Now, on the other hand, there may be some investors waiting to see whether the Fed will follow the footsteps of the ECB and accelerate its bond purchases in order to avoid any unwarranted tightening in financial conditions due to the rise in bond yields. However, several Fed officials have noted that the rally in borrowing costs just reflects the optimism over a rapid recovery, brushing aside concerns about the return to the dysfunction in markets that dominated the early days of the coronavirus pandemic. Thus, we don't expect the Fed to ease further either, especially with market sentiment improving towards the end of last week. Now, with all that in mind, both groups of investors are likely to get disappointed, and thus we don't expect the US dollar to react much at the time of the release. It could gain slightly if officials present upside revisions to their economic forecasts due to the COVID vaccinations proceeding at a fast pace, as well as due to President Biden's massive fiscal stimulus package being signed into law. That said, we stick to our guns that the greenback is likely to come back under selling pressure as inflation fears continue to ease, while equities are likely to continue to trend north. Now, as for the rest of today's events, on the data front, the most important one seems to be Canada's CPIs for February. The headline rate is expected to have risen to 1.3% year over year from 1%, but the core one is anticipated to have slid to 1.4% from 1.6%. At last week's gathering, the Bank of Canada stood pat, noting that the economic recovery continues to require extraordinary monetary policy support and that the 2% inflation goal is not expected to be sustainably achieved until into 2023, which means that any QE tapering may be unlikely in the next months. Although officials kept the door open that from the rising headline CPI combined with a sliding core rate would mean that any increase in consumer prices may be due to the rise in oil prices, and thus it may be temporary. This will confirm the bank's view and may lessen even more the tapering likelihood. Now, Eurozone's final CPIs for February are also coming out and they are expected to confirm their preliminary estimates. While in the US, we get building permits and housing starts for the same month, with the forecasts pointing to small declines. As for tonight, during the Asian session Thursday, New Zealand's GDP for the fourth quarter is due to be released, with the forecast pointing to a slowdown to 0.1% quarter over quarter from 14%, something that would, however, take the year-over-year rate up to 0.5% from 0.4%. A few hours later, we get Australia's employment report for February. The unemployment rate is forecast to have ticked down to 6.3% from 6.4%, while the net change in employment is anticipated to show that the Australian economy has gained 30,000 jobs after adding 29,100 in January. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 8 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.